Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? The Perseid meteor shower peaks on August 12th at 1300 hours universal time. So the Perseids are bits of gravel and dust and other things that comet Temple Tuttle left behind as it has gone around the sun a number of times and it crosses Earth's orbital path. And as it does so, it tends to leave those bits that the Earth then plows through around that same time every single year. So we call that the Perseid meteor shower. Now, where do we actually go to see these? Well, pretty much anywhere up. You don't need a telescope. You don't really need binoculars if you want to use them to see some of the brighter smoke trails that are left behind. You can do that. But mostly you really just need your eyes. And that's all that's required for us to be able to see meteors. And you want to see as much sky as possible. So ideally, the best thing to do is get comfortable on either a lawn chair or lay down on a blanket or any way that you can lean back and look up at the sky and see as much of it as possible with as little light pollution as you can as well. Because the darker that your sky is, the more meteors that you'll see. Now, the Perseids produce up to 90 meteors per hour. Now, that seems like a lot, but in reality, you won't see that many. Very often on a good year, I might see as many as a dozen in an hour, and that just is because you can't look at the entire sky at once. That's okay. Just whatever direction that you're looking, try to capture as many as you can and try to look towards the peak. But the great thing about the Perseids is they tend to go from about a week or two beforehand to about a week or two after, with the majority of them occurring within a day or two of that peak. So we get a lot of opportunity to be able to see those meteors. So ideally what you want to do is face that chair or your body if you're laying down on the ground towards the north-northwest. Perseus will be rising over in the eastern part of the sky, the northeastern area, but we don't need to look directly at Perseus. What we want to do is look up and away from there. So generally overhead-ish or just whatever's comfortable for your neck. You don't want to be leaning back way like this because that can get uncomfortable on your neck after a while. But what you can do is just look in that general direction kind of up and try to see as many as you're able to capture. So although that peak occurs during the mid-afternoon hours for the United Kingdom and sometime in the early daylight morning hours for us here in the United States, what you can do to optimize your opportunity to see as many of the Perseids as possible is try to look late at night and then towards midnight. Now, the issue that we're going to have is that a late waning gibbous moon is going to wind up rising right about the time that would be the ideal moment for us to be able to start looking at the meteors, which is after midnight. So you may want to try for that 10:30 to midnight hour and a half window if you can. That may be the best opportunity for you to be able to see as many meteors as possible with as little moonlight interfering as possible. And of course, that's also during the middle of the work week. So while many of us may be working at home and have the opportunity to sleep in a little bit longer, it's still during the week, so we don't want to stay up all night necessarily, unless you have no work the next day, in which case, stay up all night. See what you can see. But for most of us, we're going to want to try to aim for that. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.